rapping a cappella. Whoa. Kim Trezor, people with the weather. Whoa. I got it, boy, don't make me be the devil. Whoa. He knocking on the door and know the password. Woo. Gave me his blessings, why I'm hotter than the last verse. Woo.
Dead presidents, dead presidents. Oh, yeah. Dead presidents, hit them dead presidents. Oh,
I got that in like Tommy Lee. I make money. On my third passport in them. I got at the airport. I got Bowling Green dollars on my dollars. Busting down a hundred. In the bathtub, get some house shoes. I got money, I got war wounds. Get the coaching on that, ain't no dance moves. I was busted on the stoop, hanging with my Haitians. On the news, on front page, ain't no relations. I was stacking Ben Franks and Boston. 2 times in a row, that's a repeat. You end up in a. Cause they easy. I'm in the freezy. She got a, she love me like she need me. I got my Maybach flooded out with extra TVs. I make a pickup every single day. I judge a vulture when I flip the padded face.
Dead presidents, dead presidents. Dead presidents, hit them dead presidents.
Damn.
Boy, fresh, you know who got the trophy. 16 when I bought my first Rollie. Legend in my hood, just like a never riding in the extra car.
Dead presidents, dead presidents. Dead presidents, hit them dead presidents.
Let's go, I'm a little military.
Dead presidents, dead presidents. Dead presidents, dead presidents.
Today, and there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's the Saints going up against the Browns.
Thank you, Larry. From the shores of Lake Erie, EA Sports has coverage of the NFL from First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. This was the scene a few minutes ago. The dog pound in full roar as their Browns emerge from their tunnel. And they're ready to go as they get set to match up with Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. So the D-line's going to spread out. A first carry now for Adrian Peterson. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Breeze now. Here's a screen to Powell. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jamie Collins. And now a timeout called defensively by the Browns. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Coleman, the man in motion left. Coleman, the man in motion right. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Now Breeze. And Ginn's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. From the gun, it's Breeze. Connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. That'll bring up second down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Back to the ground, Peterson. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only the controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to...
And the pressure gets to Breeze as he's taken down.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Breeze gonna throw. Over the middle to catch by Coleman. Touchdown, New Orleans. Brandon Coleman, 39 yards. And the Saints have taken the early lead. Coming into the year, Breeze, 465 touchdown passes, add another one to the total.
You know, it's funny, I just talked with his college head coach, and he told me that when Drew was a sophomore at Purdue, they weren't sure he was truly the starter, even though he started the opening game, and he made a play early in that one where the coach got on the headset and told the rest of the staff, "Well, fellas, we found our quarterback. Now we got to make sure we find the rest of our team."
Breeze hasn't looked back since. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
Let's go!
Well, they'll go with a wide receiver run here. It's Coleman. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And this is picked up by the Saints. And his guys will take over at the 14-yard line in the red zone. The Saints put up 29 points a game last year, second only to the Falcons, and they're in range to get some points on this drive as well. First and 10. They run the counter now. It's Peterson. And he's going to get about four down inside the 10 to the 9.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Again, Peterson. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Adrian Peterson, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Saints add on to their lead. And it's good to make it 14-0. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. Now it's Duke Johnson here on the return. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. Charles, for the Cleveland Browns, as they come back out here on offense, now, their quarterback battle wasn't really just a two-man battle. It's really a three-man battle right now going into the season, isn't it?
And I'm not sure they anticipated that. They knew if they drafted a quarterback, which they did in DeShone Kizer, he would be in the game. But acquiring Brock Osweiler was a little bit of a surprise to everyone, and many thought that he wouldn't even be with the team come training camp. Instead, he's firmly in the thick of this battle.
And he's taken down here by the Saints. Tyler Damison. With a great push up front, he picks up the sack and a loss of 8. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Kizer now on second down. He's going to air one out. And got his man complete. And he takes it all the way down to the 3. A big play that time for Cleveland. 76 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaughton. The Browns with a football to begin quarter number 2, and they've got it here with a first down. They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. First down and goal, the offense knocking on the door. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Second down, Kizer. This will be caught just inside the 10. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal. Sneak it, trying to barrel up in there, but I don't think he got it. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a 4th down.
To me, this isn't even a question. I think that they'll go. When they have a chance to put a dent in the lead, even with a whole second half to play, I think they have to do it. This isn't a risk. This is a necessity.
Game to try to get in, and this will depend on the mark. I'm not sure he pushed the line forward, and indeed he did not. They